This is Sal, and I'm still at Stanford Medical School with Dr. Connolly.
Yep, Sal, we're going to continue going. You're going to have to get one unit of credit for today.
Oh, excellent. Okay. My mother would be proud.
So what we're going to look at today is a colon polyp. We had said before, polyp is something that's going to stick up like this.
See. So that in that last video, what we saw, it was not a polyp. That was like an irritated part of the bowel?
Yeah, it was very low lying. It was.
Let me get you the pen here. We got it all tangled up.
It was really just kind of a patch of irritant right there.
I see.
So we've got a bigger piece now.
I see. That's why it just looks okay. Everything looks more.
So you can see the glands look tiny in here.
So roughly that last slide, how big would it be on this?
It would be about a piece like that.
I see.
And to be fair, it probably was what was underlying this area right here.
I see.
And then it grew on to be something more than that.
It wasn't this exact one.
No, it wasn't.
It could grow on to be something like this.
It could
polyp.
Grow on to. So this is something where when we have a colon resection, if there's a cancer, often there's a polyp.
Right.
There's an area of that patch like
right.
we saw with hyperplasia.
That not necessarily where the cancer is. It's in that same section of colon.
Yeah, we find that people, if they have a colon cancer, often they have lots of other pre-cancer lesions.
I see. Because maybe their bowel is just going through a lot of trauma.
Some of it's familial susceptibility, but a lot of it is that they are showing a propensity to this.
I see.
Don't know if it's from environmental exposures or what.
I see. So. And just to remind myself on what we're doing here, so you cut out a bit of colon. You can just view it as a tube because there was some cancer there.
Right.
And then this thing might be some other polyp that's sitting in that same section that you cut out.
Yeah.
And then maybe that second slide we saw with the irritation, that could be like right there or something.
Yeah.
I see.
As a matter of fact, it's important that you normally wouldn't see this slide in a patient because almost all polyps, the colonoscopist is coming in and they remove it.
I see.
Through the colonoscope.
I see, because they don't know if they're cancerous or not.
They don't know if it's not. They'll remove it, but you wouldn't see the full wall. So right out here, I mean, that's all the way through the wall in which you've got muscle.
Oh, I see.
Here.
I see.
So that's the muscular part of the wall. And so this is the, really kind of going down to a full piece of the wall.
I see. Wow.
So this is a larger piece, and this is in order to show the polyp in its natural environment.
Right.
So what we're going to do is we're going to begin looking at the polyp here. And so we'll first start way out here, which is to go back again to the normal architecture.
Right, right.
So we had said there's supposed to be tubes. Luckily, this one, it's cut right down the middle of the tube, so you can see how big the hole is supposed to be.
Right.
And so, yeah, this is normal architecture there. And then if I just go out a little bit and I'm just going to come along, you can see that you have an area here in which there's a bit of irritation. So it's thrown up a little bit like we saw before, but the real trouble is this thing sticking out.
Right.
And we wonder, what is that thing sticking out? And so for the medical students, we try to tell them to think like the way the pathologist would be, that you first need to look at the overall architecture.
Right.
This is an abnormal architecture.
Yes.
You don't usually have bumps sticking out.
Yeah.
Then the next thing you're going to do
in 3D would look like a mushroom?
Like a mushroom. They tend to have foldings on the top of them, so a little more like cauliflower.
Oh, I see.
Because they tend to be cauliflower color.
I see.
So then when you look here.
They're that color too? They're the color of cauliflower?
Yeah, they don't have much color to them.
Oh,
and in fact, the colonoscopist, when they look at a polyp, can kind of tell if there's a chance of cancer because they begin having weird blood vessels in
it. I see. And just to be clear, so they're not this purplish color that we're seeing in
this
slide.
No,
this is artificial color added.
Thin section, and we had to put this – it would be colorless otherwise.
I see.
So we had to put a stain
on
it.
Right. Makes sense.
So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw the area where I'm going to do a comparison. See this thingamabob here?
Yeah.
Oh, you're going to
love
this.
Look at that.
So now
miracles of science.
Yeah, it's great.
Technology.
So these are cells which are relatively normal. These are cells which are abnormal. And when we look at them, a pathologist immediately says these look angry.
They do. They do look angry. I would say that too.
And so when you look, so what's angry about them is, first of all, they're not committed to being, to behaving. Proper behavior over here, nuclei belong at the bottom.
Right.
The things that you're supposed to do for your job, J-O-B, are at the top.
Yes.
And
yes.
So when you look at these guys, it's like, where's your job?
Yes.
And so a few of them are making mucin, but these ones have nuclei of different sizes and shapes.
Yeah, and they're all just...
They're just doing their own thing.
And they're not even doing mucin.
Some make mucin, but a lot of them, all they're doing is growing.
Right.
And so usually there's a playoff between that if you're committed to your specific job, for,
right.
we call it differentiation.
Right, right.
So if you're committed to your differentiation, you tend not to have as much propensity to grow.
Yeah.
And if you tend to grow a lot, you
yes.
tend not to do the differentiation. And so this is largely that you have this sort of chaos of nuclei, less commitment to the normal structures,
right.
and you're not producing as much. And so what this is now called dysplasia.
Dysplasia.
D-Y-S.
Right. So it's doing the wrong thing.
And so, yes, the wrong growth.
Right, right.
And so that's what we're just saying is we don't like the looks of these ones. And so these individual cells look dysplastic and they grow. So then to tell whether it's cancer,
mm-hmm.
cancer means in this organ that you've grown across this line in the sand.
So let me. So literally, so if you've crossed this boundary right over here, cancer.
Right.
So even if I'm in the polyp up here and I'm controlling uncontrollably, you know, mm-hmm. cancer cells and it's mutated and it's not killing itself with what
right.
it's supposed to, you still would not call it officially cancer?
No. So what happens is that there's a middle term
right.
where it's a cancer in the still in the usual place.
Right.
And that's carcinoma in situ.
See. Okay.
So that's carcinoma in situ means it's not an invasive cancer, and
right.
therefore most people would not really call it a cancer. It's just so wild looking up here,
right.
you know that it would do that if it was given any chance or time.
I see. So what we're saying is if something was out here,
mm-hmm.
a carcinoma in situ,
yeah.
Yeah, that eventually it probably would make its way.
Yeah, it just looks so
keep growing
committed
until,
to growth and
right.
so aggressive and
right.
so little differentiation
right.
that you know if you gave it time, you'd worry
no,
that
it
would
makes,
grow.
Makes sense.
So with here, though, this is dysplasia.
Right.
Where it's very upsetting that it's growing so fast.
Right.
But what's important about this
right.
is in hyperplasia,
right.
if you took away the stimulus or irritant,
right.
it would go back to normal.
Yes.
This will not.
I see. Like we said, like if there's some irritant, in the last video we said like a week mm-hmm. later, a couple of weeks later, that hyperplasia would go away.
Right.
Dysplasia is here to stay.
That's
this
right. And so the key word we use is autonomous.
Autonomous.
It's doing its own
thing.
It's
independent. Right,
it's just
right.
whatever. So it will grow no matter what. It doesn't care about clues from neighboring cells.
Right.
It doesn't need something driving it. So what you have then is this is growing.
Right.
And if it's growing and it's all by itself and growing, it's then called a neoplasia. So
neoplasia.
That's our last plasia.
Right. So neoplasia showing dysplasia.
Yeah. So dysplasia just right. is more of when you go into look at these guys, these features.
Oh, it's like this particular feature.
These cells right. aren't growing right.
I see. And so that's an example of dysplasia.
Right. That's dysplasia. And then overall, this lump
right.
is a new growth.
New growth.
It's a neoplasia.
Right.
And we reserve it in the medical field for meaning it's growing on its own.
And how do we know it's new? Because as you said, it sticks around.
Yeah.
Like the hyperplasia. So how do we know this wasn't around for like a year?
Oh, it probably was. So
oh, okay.
I think it actually came from an area here.
Mm-hmm.
And the thinking would be that you probably had irritants or hyperplasia.
Right.
It would continue to grow. Cells
right.
divide too much. And then one of them made a mistake.
I see.
And so then it clicked on something where it would say, you know what? From now on, I'm not listening to any
right.
clues.
It kept working, and then all of its descendants were crazy too.
That's
yes.
right. So then
yes.
it would then have a real mean streak.
Yes.
And so then they would grow from here. So this is an area where you can see.
I see that pattern in my own family.
So. Yeah, exactly.
So
then here, these are more normal glands, but
right.
even these,
yes.
that's dysplasia.
Right, right.
So these are growing, and they do not have a good pattern of growth.
Right.
And overall, this lump
right.
is a neoplasia.
I see. So when we say new, it's kind of newer than the other tissue.
Yeah, we don't really mean so much the new for meaning that's newer than the others as much as it's its own thing.
I see.
New,
okay.
new kid on the block.
Okay.
And so right. this is the neoplasia here.
I see.
All right, so this one here is a polyp. It has features of dysplasia.
Right.
But we would say we see no cancer.
I see. How would you know that?
And
you,
so, and
oh right, because it never crossed the boundary line.
And this is there's a reason why the boundary is important. Is that if you look here, these are all the surface cells. Down here, that these are the vessels that go to the rest of the body.
Right.
So these are blood vessels.
Right.
These ones are called lymphatics. And what lymphatics are is they just take the clear fluid
right.
around there. So
these. These right here, these are the lymphatics, the clear fluid.
Right.
And there is fluid can go back and forth between blood vessels and the lymph system.
Yeah, so, usually so what happens is that Blood comes in an artery like this,
right.
goes on down to these little vessels, and then a little bit of the clear parts of it
right.
will kind of leak out into
like the red blood cells are too big
to yeah,
kind of leak
they'll
out.
Stay
right,
in there.
Right, right.
So then the lymph is the clear stuff that comes out, and then this is how it gets back to the rest of your body or through these lymphatics. So you can see you do not want neoplastic cells in
there. Right, because once in there, they can get to any part of the body.
Go any place, and then guess what? Set up shop, new kids on the block, they just do what
right,
they want to do.
Metastasis.
Metastasis. Yeah. So metastasis would be if it gets right. into these things,
right.
it can get out of the colon
and go anywhere in
a hurry.
The body. Right.
So this is one where it is not cancer, and it has not invaded these areas where it gets to the rest of the body.
Fascinating.